Welcome back to our channel, where we delve into the extraordinary and explore the unknown. Today, we're embarking on an exhilarating journey into the depths of scientific curiosity, where we'll unravel mysteries and challenge conventional wisdom. Join us as we venture into uncharted territory and uncover the secrets of the universe. Today, we're deploying an immense bomb into the Mariana Trench, but we're not halting there. We're also intending to nuke a hurricane and a volcano. What occurs when you deposit one of the deadliest arms acknowledged by humanity into the world's most exceptional natural marvels? Let's commence our nuclear test by plunging a nuke into the Mariana Trench. How would you transport a nuke to the base of the What if we nuked the Mariana Trench? Mariana Trench? What would this underwater blast be like, and what type of destruction would it cause? This is What If, and here's what would transpire if we nuked the Mariana Trench. Welcome to the deepest, darkest realms of the ocean. The Mariana Trench is situated in the western Pacific Ocean, just 360 kilometers away from the island of Guam. You'd be descending 11 kilometers down to Challenger Deep, the trench's deepest point. Here, you could stack around 30 Empire State Buildings atop each other before hitting the surface. You'd be amidst the brave few to venture into these high-pressure, pitch-black, and nearly freezing waters, joining the ranks of scientists, a naval officer, and even filmmaker James Cameron. But you'd be transporting the most precious cargo of all, the largest nuclear bomb ever crafted. Okay, wait before you concern yourself with what would transpire if you detonated a bomb at the trench's bottom. You'd need to devise a safe delivery method. If a bomb accidentally detonated near the surface, it could pose a danger to numerous individuals. You could visualize it as a massive nuclear tsunami, with waves hundreds of meters high spreading out in all directions. This could engender a perilous scenario for the islands neighboring the Mariana Trench, such as Guam, Japan, or the Philippines. Fortunately, these waves would behave differently than your typical tsunami waves. They'd break earlier, meaning they'd be smaller and less catastrophic upon reaching land. Nevertheless, it's still preferable to avert this crisis and securely transport that bomb down into the trench. To achieve this, you'd have to shield it from the incredibly high pressures at the trench's bottom. The pressure there is so immense that it would be akin to having 100 adult elephants on your head. You'd want to employ a specialized pressure vessel for transporting the bomb, akin to Operation Wigwam in 1955. The United States detonated a bomb at a depth of 600 meters, which was twice as potent as the bomb dropped on Hiroshima. The explosion generated a massive bubble across the water, with deadly radioactive contamination spreading across 13 square kilometers. However, your bomb would be the most colossal nuke ever devised, more akin to the SAR Bomba. This nuclear weapon was over 3,000 times more powerful than the little boy bomb dropped on Nagasaki, and you'd have to plunge it much deeper than the Wigwam test. At the moment of detonation, a bubble of scalding steam would expand rapidly. Within just a few seconds, it would cover an area of about 1 kilometer on the surface. You'd observe a massive bulge in the water, but it wouldn't reach great heights. That's because you'd detonate the bomb so deep that the water pressure above would force the bubble to collapse. Nonetheless, within a few seconds, that bubble would shrink, then commence expanding outward again. This expansion and contraction would persist for 3 or 4 cycles, leaving the water turbulent, hot, and infused with radioactive debris. At least neighboring coastal cities wouldn't have to fret about being obliterated by a tsunami. Nonetheless, you certainly wouldn't witness the effects ending there. The heightened temperatures from the explosion could generate intense hurricanes, and the turbulent waters and radioactive material would have adverse effects on marine life. There would be mass casualties from the explosion, and deep-sea fish could be blinded by the bright flash of light. Over time, you could observe unforeseen or surprising effects on the ecosystem near the detonation site. There are corals as large as cars after the 23 detonations at the U.S. nuclear testing site on Bikini Atoll, not to mention an abundance of aquatic animal life. However, you could witness mutations in marine life after some time. Now, that's what would occur if we nuked the Mariana Trench. But let's transition our nuclear weaponry from the sea all the way up to the sky. What if we nuked a hurricane? Let's nuke a hurricane. Every year, about half a dozen hurricanes reach the United States, bringing effects ranging from strong winds and some flooding to the devastation of communities, destroying homes, and claiming lives. Instead of bracing for impact with sandbags and survival kits, what if hurricanes never made landfall at all? What if we could halt these hurricanes by nuking them? How would we go about it? Could this trigger a nuclear apocalypse, or would a bomb even halt a hurricane? This is What If, and here's what would happen if we nuked a hurricane. But first, what precisely are hurricanes? They are massive storms that form over warm ocean water near the equator. Hurricanes are tropical storms. The water they form over needs to be above 26 degrees Celsius for them to form. This warm water creates humid air, which is then thrust upward by tropical winds to create storm clouds. Lighter winds outside the clouds steer them and aid in their development. This cycle persists until the storm reaches winds of at least 119 kilometers per hour. At that stage, it's labeled a hurricane. They're typically around 160 kilometers in diameter and can be nearly as extensive as the state of Texas. Oh yes, and did we mention that these phenomena can endure for days? You certainly don't want this approaching your residence, so let's nuke it. Surprisingly, the notion of nuking hurricanes isn't novel. It's been suggested for decades, tracing back to the 1950s. The concept operates as follows: a submarine would maneuver underwater to below the storm's eye. Once there, the sub would deploy the nuclear device, initiating an explosion aimed at displacing the hot air and introducing cold air, which is denser. The cold air would decelerate the wind and halt the hurricane. Okay, we have our nuke and are prepared to launch it. There it goes, and well, nothing occurred, the hurricane persists. That can't be promising. The rationale behind the inactivity is due to the hurricane's immense energy output. According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, the heat discharged from a hurricane is equivalent to a 10-megaton nuclear bomb detonating every 20 minutes. In 1990, all of humanity consumed 20% less energy than a single hurricane produces. So, contemporary bombs would scarcely make a dent on a hurricane. Furthermore, the hurricane would transport all that radiation, plutonium, and other civilization-endangering materials from the air down to the land. As if a conventional hurricane wasn't dire enough, we'd now face a radioactive one. As it traversed across America, it would devastate cities with its wind and water while also saturating them with radiation. Okay, let's attempt this again. This time we'll utilize an even more substantial bomb, and we mean truly massive. To possess adequate energy and force to impede a hurricane, you'd necessitate over 100 atomic bombs. But to simplify matters, let's condense all that power into one colossal bomb. If we released such an enormous bomb, it would undoubtedly halt the most epic of hurricanes. However, once the debris settles, you'd swiftly realize that you've obliterated most of the Earth in the process. So, regardless of the method, attempting to nuke a hurricane is ill-advised. Unfortunately, the frequency of hurricanes continues to escalate. Researchers assert that the ocean's warming due to climate change is a contributing factor to the intensification and increased frequency of hurricanes. And no, we can't nuke that predicament either. Thus, nuking a hurricane is an abominable idea. For our